frequently it is necessary to employ abutments which are in some manner less than ideal. If tooth loss is anticipated in the longer term, the partial may be designed to maintain the serviceability of the prosthesis. In this scenario, a mandibular Kennedy class 1 arch is restored with a removable partial denture. Number 20. The periodontal prognosis is guarded. The prognosis for all others is good. Number 21. No definite mesial or distal fossae exists. 6 mm exists from the free gingival margin to the elevated floor of the mouth. Unlimited patient funds, but no implants or FPDs. Patient is not aesthetic conscious. Number 21. High frenal attachment exists. No buccal bone or soft tissue undercuts are present which would interfere with the path of placement. The patient refuses to have any surgical procedures. We gathered from our clinical examination that number 20 has a guarded periodontal prognosis. Number 21 has no distinct fossa which would conveniently lend itself to rest seat preparation, but with some minor reshaping we can use the lingual cusp with a hood rest, similar to a plated cingulum rest. Short guide planes are prepared on the terminal primary abutments. Composite cingulum are prepared on the cuspids, chevron-shaped cingulum rest seats are prepared. These rest seats provide support to the major connector and will allow the major connector to function as an indirect retainer. A mesio-occlusal rest seat is prepared on tooth number 21. Following our clinical examination, the lingual bar major connector is not indicated due to insufficient vestibular space. A lingual plate is advantageous both to limit rotation in the horizontal plane, known as fishtailing, as well as anterior-posterior rocking as an indirect retainer. This factor is increasingly important with the loss of alveolar ridge height, loss of posterior molar abutments, and the U-shaped nature of the mandibular arch. The major connector also maximizes the available cross-arch support. Ladder or mesh retained acrylic is helpful for the altered cast impression and future aligning. It is easily added and can be used to retain embedded wrought wire used in any necessary repair. The ladder is always terminated with a tissue stop. The ladder should have sufficient space for 1.5 mm of acrylic under the metal. The acrylic base is easily repaired, replaced and adjusted. A buccal frenal attachment interfering with the placement of a bar retainer is present on number 20. Mesial retention can be attained with a flexible 19-gauge wrought wire clasp utilizing 0.02 inches undercut. For symmetry and simplicity of design and uniformity of retention, a similar clasp is used on number 27. The wrought wire is easy to adjust and may be used in most situations. Should the primary abutment fail, the partial has been designed to be easily repaired and returned to a state of serviceability, usually with same-day repair facilitated with an alginate pickup impression and a skilled dental laboratory technician. If care is used, minimal adjustment will be required to seat and adjust the partial denture.